he hadn't shot the ball well. Maybe to his standards, hasn't played well, but and then gets hurt, comes back, and finds a way. But you know, when it comes to competition, there's no one better. So he enjoyed being able to have that opportunity. You know, Kai was great. We have Q come off the bench, make some big threes for us, and then Marshall's defense ability, you know, for us to be able to guard. You know, I thought PJ did a really good job on everyone that he guarded tonight. But when you look at Luka, I mean, as someone just said, it's, you know, we've seen this movie before, and he loves the opportunity to win the game. He's not scared, and he stepped up and made a big shot.
Yeah, you mentioned Kyrie and talked about him before the game, but was there some type of conversation at halftime when Luka was injured for him to be a little bit more assertive on the offensive end?
No, I don't think we were concerned about Luka's injury. It was more or less, what can we do better? Right, we got, you know, Edwards off the three-point line after that first shoot-around, that first quarter that they had shoot-around. And then understanding the ball movement, and then understanding the physicality had to have an uptick. And I thought the group responded there at halftime, even though they went on a 10-0 run. I thought the group responded after that. I think we went on a 16-2 run, you know, to respond to their run. And every time they made a run, I thought Kai stepped up and made a big shot for us, and that's just his leadership.
You know, you mentioned they closed with a bucket a few times there in the fourth quarter, late. What's your comfort level knowing you've got Luka, you've got Kyrie, two of the best creators and shot makers in those situations?
Yeah, the confidence is extremely high. When you look at being able to finish something that we talked about here in the last 2 years, is we feel comfortable that we're going to get a wide open look. And then understanding the difficulty of some of the shots that those two guys that you brought up, Luka and Kai, can make. And so, one, those two aren't afraid of the moment, but they can also find an open guy to get a wide open three. And so just understanding the time and score, Kai has the game going, ball was in his hands, and he made some big shots. And then I thought, you know, being able to come up with some offensive rebounds, D-Live has been a monster for us all season of giving us second or third opportunities.
Phoenix was also a very physical game a couple games ago, and this one was very physical tonight, even in the short time. How have you seen the growth from the guys and just being able to calm the noise and the physicality and everything that's going on out there?
I think it's just basketball. We're trying to figure out which way they're going to officiate it right now, in the sense of, is it going to be physical or is it going to be, you know, non-physical? So I thought, again, the group did a great job of being physical. We took them off the three-point line. They made some there in that fourth. But I thought just our execution, our poise, with those two as our quarterback, and I think having Clay in these close games too, because we're getting used to him being able to run stuff with him involved as a screen setter. And then there late, we saw, you know, Luka and Clay on the backside. You're talking two of the best shooters in the league. And so a lot of stuff that we've learned here early in the season, going to Phoenix, not playing well there. They were on a back-to-back. Us coming here on the back-to-back, understanding if we, you know, put our best foot forward to give ourselves a chance to win on the road, and we did that tonight.
You mentioned Lively. Three out of the four games now, he's had pretty solid rebounding games. You know, what is the kind of emphasis has that been for you and for your staff talking to him?
Go get it. You know, a lot of times with the Reds or the switching that's taking place, he's got a small, so he's taking full advantage of the opportunity of going to get the rebounds against the smalls with the switching. And so, again, if he's not putting it back, he's trying to find, you know, the three-point shooters or getting the ball back to our quarterbacks. But he's done an incredible job of being able to offensive rebound, or if not, you know, the Tyson being able to tip it out. And so we just need that activity. If you get that activity with a live body like D-Live there in the fourth quarter, it gives you a second opportunity or a third opportunity offensively. And a lot of times if you do, you're going to be able to score.
Your offense only had 10 turnovers. They had 20. I think there's like a 20-point differential on points off turnovers. Just what did you see on both ends of that led to that success?
Yeah, we had too many turnovers there in the first half. I think we had 8 or something like that. And so we only had, I think, 1 there in the second. So we're a team that takes care of the ball. We take pride in taking care of the ball. we had some turnovers that were not careless, but the intent was right on the break, being able to throw the ball ahead. And so, again, we've talked a lot about our quarterbacks, but there's other guys that touched the ball too, and they did a great job of taking care of the ball. And we've said if we can take care of the ball, we're going to get a good look, and tonight we did that.
You know, speaking of the switching in the fourth quarter, you know, Najee was the initiator a couple times where Kyrie was on the elbow and horn sets, and you were able to get like some favorable mismatches. Just how valuable is it to have like those forwards that can handle the ball like you talked about before?
Yeah, when you talk about Marshall's ability to handle his basketball IQ, being able to have our forwards get in the offense, PJ's another one. And so the luxury of learning what we went through in the finals last year, when the more playmakers you can have on the floor, the game becomes simple and it becomes easier. And so being able to have Najee, I thought he did a great job for us tonight, getting us in our offense and being able to recognize what we were trying to do and get the matchup that we wanted offensively.
I know it's only the fourth game of the season, but did this game feel like a playoff game, or did it have something similar intensity?
Yeah, the intensity. Everybody's trying to win. You know, understanding how tough it is in the West, every game means something. And so I thought, again, last night we haven't played our best. I thought this was a step forward in playing better Mavs basketball as a team. And so now being able to, we're going to have a home stand here. We'll be home for a while. We got to be able to protect home. But this is definitely a win that we can build on.
Got a little scared. You know, a lot of injuries happening. Felt a little bit, but it was fine. Yeah, it was pretty sure now.
Yeah, could you take us through what happened on that play?
Yeah, I stopped and somebody like knee me from behind and my knee went forward, so it was not good feelings.
Yeah, and then for you to, just the 3-point struggles and you to get that those couple to fall during the fourth quarter, including the dagger, just what was that like for you out there?
Just, I don't know how I can make those shots and not the normal shots. Just I don't know how I do. But at the end of the day, you know, just gotta get resting us out, and I'll be back. I didn't play the whole preseason, you know, it's been, so I need some time, but we got the win, man. That's all that matters.
I think if my Slovenian's good after you hit the step back there, you said that's what I effing do. How comfortable are you in those situations, game on the line, ball in your hands?
Pretty comfortable. You know that we have me, Clay, Kai, those two guys, you know, anybody can take a shot. We know sometimes they're going to double us. If somebody's hot in this situation, they double Kai, so I'm the opportunity to shoot it. So we got to say thank you to Kai.
And to do it on this floor again with the fans who adore you so much?
Oh, yeah, I heard a lot of stuff. They really like me here, so. But, you know, it's last year was fun. It's a big moment in my career, in my life. So it was fun to be back here.
Luka, you make a surge at the end of a game tonight, the second night of a back-to-back. How do you feel about your endurance and your win now a few games in?
We feel great. You know, I think we're 3-1. We still got, we're not close to our highest level, not even close. But I think our defense, outside, I think the finish game is looking pretty good. You know, we trust each other, everybody helping each other, so but we still got a lot of improvement left.